So, it's Black Friday when this gets released, and I'll get back to why this matters in a second. But this also means that we're getting closer to the end of the year. And of course, obviously, closer to the start of the next year. And whilst I will probably create a separate episode later this year where I look back to this year and give you my personal thoughts about this year and how this year has been for me, in case anyone cares, whilst I will do this, I figured it might now be also a good idea, since we're approaching the end and therefore the start of the new year, to kind of reflect on the current state of the industry, at least my thoughts on it. And with that, of course, I mean the industry for us developers, web developers. So how easy or hard it is to get a job and what the future might hold for us developers. Now, as I mentioned, it's Black Friday. And I want to be fully transparent here. I'm also creating this video because, of course, I offer my courses at huge discounts today. And not just my courses, which you can get individually at huge discounts, but also the Academine Pro annual membership. We're offering that at a huge discount as well. You can get it for $149 instead of $249. And with that, you get full access to all my courses, including some exclusive courses, which you find only on that website. And of course, that's an amazing offer with limited slots, by the way. We only have 500 slots, and last year we sold 500 slots, so you might want to be fast, but I want to be fully transparent here that this is, of course, one reason why I create this episode here, but it's not the only one. But I don't want this episode to feel like I searched for some reason to create it and then, hey, it's a sale. But instead, no, we are approaching that new year. We are approaching the end of this year. And I feel like sharing my thoughts about the current state of web development and so on might be relevant to some of you, at least. And if you do then decide that maybe it might still be a good idea to learn web development or become better at web development, then the mentioned offers might be interesting to you. And of course, you find links to them in the description. But with that out of the way, what is the current state of the industry? It's all great, right? You should learn web development and buy my courses. Well, yeah, it's not that simple, I'd say. It's also not that horrible, or not as horrible as some people might want you to believe, but of course, it's been a rough year. It's been a rough year, just like last year has also been already a bit rougher. I mean, we're coming from a level in the COVID days where everyone wanted to hire developers and everyone wanted to learn writing code, therefore, of course. We're coming from that level, and obviously, we're not on that level anymore. Many companies have cut costs and have therefore drastically, sometimes, reduced the number of developers they employ. There have been job losses and there are less jobs available for developers than in the past. And then, of course, we have AI. And AI, of course, also is there to take our jobs, right? Well, we'll have to see whether that's really the case, but I did create separate episodes about that and I don't want to bore you. The short summary is that for me, AI is a tool that can be extremely useful. It can also be dangerous. You can overuse it. You can use it inefficiently and actually become a worse developer. But if used right, you can really boost your productivity. And that is one of the main reasons why recently, a couple of weeks ago, I released a course where I try to share my best practices or my personal insights on how I use AI tools like GitHub Copilot and Cursor to hopefully be a bit more efficient. So that might be interesting for you too. But I don't believe that AI is there to take our jobs today or tomorrow or anytime soon. However, it's definitely possible that a bit less developers are needed, because if every individual developer is a bit more efficient, which is yet to be proven, which is not necessarily the case, but if that were the case, then of course we might need fewer developers. However, on the other hand, of course, you could also say that if every developer gets a bit more efficient and gets a bit better, there's simply more that could be done. So more companies might actually hire developers or start new projects where they need developers because they can get more done with the same number of developers they had before. So even that, even the rise of AI is not necessarily something that leads to less developers being needed. And the future of AI writing all the code or no code to be written at all, because we're all just interacting with AI first applications. Yeah, I don't feel like that future is directly around the corner. Now, of course, this doesn't change the fact, though, that there are less jobs than there have been 2 or 3 years ago. And I'll be honest here, we will probably not go back to that level anytime soon. I wouldn't rule it out in general in the future, because, of course, it's still a growing industry. The internet and computers, this all still matters, and software still is super important, obviously, and controls almost every aspect of our daily life. So I don't see that changing anytime soon. There are still plenty of opportunities and problems to be solved with software, and guess who writes the software? Developers will. But we clearly have been in a bubble 2 or 3 years ago. And we thought, like, yeah, we need to digitize and everything right now, and it's all just digital in the future. There won't be any real connections between humans anymore and stuff like that. And of course, that was not how it turned out. Thankfully, I might ask. So it's still rough. It's likely, I guess, to get better in the future, but it's not clear when that future is, of course. Will it get better next year? Will we see more jobs there? Maybe. With recent events in the US, we might really see the economy heat up next year again there. We might also see the opposite, who knows, but it's possible. We might see more money getting printed. We might see more jobs, therefore, because ultimately, of course, the US is still like the driving force behind many of those jobs and the world economy in general, you could maybe even argue. So that might be a big thing, but it's impossible to tell today, of course. However, what is something you can say with certainty today, or I can say with certainty today, because it is my strong belief, is that being able to write code and therefore being able to solve problems, because that is ultimately what you do as a developer. You solve problems all the time, no matter which programming language you're using. Maybe you're solving a bit more problems with some languages. I'm looking at you, JavaScript, but you are solving problems either way, no matter which language you use. And that's a skill that will always matter. In addition, being able to write code will always open up opportunities for you, unless we have that future where no code needs to be written anymore, which is highly unrealistic. Therefore, being able to write code always gives you more opportunities than not being able to write code. Now, of course, don't get me wrong, there are plenty of other professions out there that also matter and give you plenty of opportunities, but here we are talking about development, and that definitely does open up many doors, even if you're not getting a job right now. Now, I'm totally aware you need to earn money right now, not in the future, though that's not entirely correct. You need to earn it right now and in the future, and having opportunities in the future will therefore never hurt. And when it comes to the right now aspect, even there, you have more choices if you do know how to write code and how to build programs, how to build websites, and so on. Because, of course, you can, depending on your situation, of course, but you might be able to start your own thing. Work as a freelancer, build your own apps, your own web apps, your own software as a service companies, become an indie hacker, though I know this is a topic that's trending to the moon right now. We got guys like Peter Levels who can be really inspiring or not, depending on how you look at it. And of course, not everyone will be as successful as Peter Levels or some other guys that are in the spotlight right now. But it's definitely something you can try. You don't need to be as successful as those number one guys. Even being half or a quarter as successful will earn you decent money. And we live in a world where it's super easy to start digital businesses if you know how to write code. I guess with no code tools, even if you don't know that, but you'll always have an edge, an advantage. If you do know how to write code, you can be quicker, you can fine-tune and customize things, you can build your solution. You can also overcomplicate things, but, well, that's simply something you'll have to learn, to ship stuff, to build projects, to finish projects. But with that, being able to write code is a super useful tool in your toolbox. And it can be something you might want to try out. It can be a great alternative to finding a job as a developer. I mean, I became self-employed almost 10 years ago. I started off as a freelancer. I worked for companies. I'm to this day still building side projects and other kind of stuff. And of course, I create all these courses. And I can only do all that because I know how to write code, because I started learning it at some point. And therefore, long story short, we've definitely seen better times as developers. We're not in the world anymore where you get hired instantly at 6 or maybe even 7-digit salaries just because you know how to write some code. But it's also not as bad as it might seem. And most importantly, things will very likely change again in the future. And the question then is if you are prepared for that change, if you have skills to take advantage of that change, if you are able to write code, to stick to the development theme of this episode here, or not. And therefore, of course, in my opinion, it's still worth it to learn how to write code and to become a developer. It's still a skill that will help you. Being able to solve problems will always matter. And therefore, even though it can sometimes be discouraging to see the developments we saw this year, to see that there are less jobs available, even though all that's the case, it's no reason to be pessimistic about the future, at least in my opinion. I'm not pessimistic about the future. I'm super glad that I'm a developer and I'm looking forward to doing developer stuff and write code and build projects and websites and who knows what in the future. So these are my 2 cents on that. But of course, let me know what you think or what I missed, what your thoughts on this whole topic are.